to bathe the next. What you think this life just landed on me? My whole city look like it's abandoned, homie. And we came straight out of those abandoned homies. Every wish we ever had got granted, homie. And I never take that shit for granted. Even when the marble flowing kind of top is our granted. Back before I got paid. Hey fool man, we back again, you know. You know it's about that time, my nigga. It's story time Friday. Story time Friday. It's story time Friday, and I'm guessing this you niggas favorite series, goddamn. But yeah, we're gonna get into this story when I turned into a motherfucking Chirac savage, you feel me? And yeah, and if you don't believe me, my nigga, you can ask my nigga Twan. My nigga Twan hit him up. He'll tell you. He was like, bro, you always telling all this shit on YouTube about what I do. You tell them niggas what you do. How you be beating bitches up? I mean, I'll be beating hoes up, man. It's just like, you know, them chocolate bitches, man. I don't really fuck with them, so they can get these hands. Like, today I got time, cuz. Today I got time. I will punch a bitch. But, yeah, man. This current day right now, it was Friday. Just like how it is today. It was Friday, man, and this was my 12th grade year, and I used to have two gyms in high school because I had fucking so many credits that motherfucker I just took an extra class just in case I needed it, but so I had two gyms. After I go to the gym my first hour, and then I go to gym like I think it was like the fourth hour or some shit. No, I had gym back to back. Yeah, I had gym back to back. I had first and second or some shit. Oh, I had first and second or second and third. I don't really know. I forgot. But first hour I have it with like some other niggas. Then second or third, whatever the fuck, you know, my second gym, I had it with my boy Twan. So I wouldn't even go to the locker room. I'd just stay in the fucking gym and probably like shoot around and some shit. But you know, motherfucking gym teachers, we had like four gym teachers. Like it's like four different classes in there, and they be on bullshit. Like you ever be at school and you hooping and it's like you can be playing, like say you playing soccer or you playing tennis or volleyball. Like the gym teachers don't really give a fuck. But if you playing basketball, my nigga, they just got like some urge to not want you to play basketball. They hate when kids play basketball because they know kids love playing basketball. It's like I be shooting around, like give me the ball, Markel. Like bro, let me shoot one more. They like, you shoot one more shot, you ain't gonna have free time today. Like, man, y'all be on that bullshit. So I gave him the ball, and then this time I didn't have no choice but to go upstairs in the locker room, see who was all here. So I walk up the stairs, man, go through the, like these double doors, go in the locker room, and the locker room always fucking musty and it's full of gay ass things. Like, I mean, but this hour it wasn't because like, I don't know, like it was a whole bunch of hood ass niggas smoking weed and shit. They be smoking weed in the fucking locker room and like, and it's always musty in there. Like that's why I used to hate going in there. I always the last nigga to go in there, and I was always the last nigga to come out because it's like, I be trying to get in and get out. And plus, I don't want to be around like a whole bunch of fat ass niggas rubbing their body sweat on me. That shit is disgusting. So I go in there and go holler at my boy Twan, see we on, cause I'm ready to play basketball, man. We already know every Friday we hoop. We don't play no other sport. We don't play no volleyball. We don't play no fucking bowling, whatever the fuck they got for it. No, we playing basketball. That's all we want to do is hoop. So I'm waiting for him to get dressed, I'm hollering at him and shit. We having a good ass time talking about some bullshit. I don't really know what we was talking about, but I mean every time I talk to that nigga, we always laughing about some shit. We probably roasting somebody or something. So when we get out, when he get dressed and we walk out the door, I see his ex girlfriend. But him, I mean, that's the girlfriend that he used to like, you know, punch and shit. Like if you ever seen My Twin Is a Savage, and I think I made another one, I don't really know. But yeah, he beat that bitch up two times, and they both black, they both chocolate. I mean, Twan ain't that chocolate, but his ex girlfriend, yeah, that bitch chocolate, my nigga. Like if I didn't like that bitch chocolate, bro. I'm just leaving it at that. She blacker than the motherfucking Xfinity motherfucking internet box. Like she hella black, and he hollering at her. I mean, I really fuck with her, man, cause like she really didn't really mess with me like that. She only talked to me because it's like I was Twan, like man, so I was like no homo, but I was like his homie. Like we used to always stay together, so she ain't had no choice but to talk to me. So we'd be talking on and off when they was going out, but now that's his ex, I ain't really fuck with her like that. I might say a couple words here and there, but yeah, I just leave it at that. So he go talking to her, I go talk to this girl. And yeah, she was short. I ain't gonna give out her name, man, cause y'all niggas, bro. I said some girl name on motherfucker one of my story times. Y'all niggas found her, so no, I'm gonna leave that alone. I'm gonna go ahead and leave that alone though. But I want to go talk to this one short girl. Twan know who she is, man. She's short. She got a fat ass butt. But she used to smell like bright, like baby products. Like, but she was sexy as hell, man. Like, I should put a picture of her sexy ass up here. But I used to always holler at her, bro. I was trying to get on game, but her ass was a freshman. I was a senior, but shit, I ain't get no fuck. Call me what you want. I ain't no rapist, though. But yeah, I'm hollering at her. Then we go downstairs. We got to get in this line because, like, the teachers take their sweet ass time, my nigga. Like, our gym class is only like an hour. I think it was like an hour or like 50 minutes or some shit like that. So they take their sweet ass time while we gotta line up and wait on their ass so they can check attendance. So they, while they taking their sweet ass time, they all in the fucking lounge eating snacks, fat as hell and shit. We downstairs in line ready to hoop because it's Friday, my nigga. And then I'm talking to some homies and I'm talking to the girl, you know, with the fat ass. And I'm like, it started getting boring over there. So I just jetted off. Like, I just walked off. I go over there with Twan at. Twan talking to his ex-girlfriend and his this one girl that I went to prom with. They over there talking. And then I'm talking to Twan and we were just talking about some random shit. And then she said something smart as hell. I'm like, gee, stop fucking playing with me, man. And then she said something smart. And then I don't know what the fuck she did. I think she tried to slap me or some shit. Boy, I grabbed that motherfucking wrist. I like spun her around like on some ballerina shit. Then I fucking jumped on her neck and started choking her ass. Like I put her in this motherfucking submission. Yeah, bitch, I'm gonna need you to tap the ground 3 times so you can tap out. I'm like, I was actually choking this bitch. Like I told you niggas, I don't like chocolate hoes. Like today I got time, cuz I don't fuck with you. And we on the ground, man. We just like fucking really wrestling. She just like, she laughing like, get off of me. No, I'm not getting off you. I don't like your ass. So we on the ground. She like, Twan, get him off me. He like, shit, that ain't got nothing to do with me. Twan already beat the bitch up. It's my turn. I'm gonna catch bodies around here, man. I turned into a straight savage on that hoe. So I let her go. She get up. She try to come after me. I grab her ass again, put her in another fucking hole. Bitch, you not going nowhere. Today I got time. Yesterday I ain't have time, so I ain't really fuck with you. But today I got time, my nigga. I'm not going for none of this shit you trying to do. And the next thing, I think I slammed her ass. I like put her on her motherfucking back. And Twan said she was crying, but shit, I left that bitch alone. Cause if she would have ran up, she would have catched the fade. I ain't got time for that shit. But Twan said she was crying, and I personally don't give a fuck what the fuck she was doing, but. That should like give up that like after that day she stopped fucking messing with me because she already know what that whole life be like, bitch. You know my specialty is submissions, my nigga. I will submit your ass. Like don't fucking run up on me. I don't punch bitches though, my nigga. That's against the rules. I mean I think I said I punch bitches, damn, but that's against the rules. I don't punch bitches, but I do put bitches in submissions and I do slam their ass because you can do that. You gotta let these hoes know, man. You gotta show them who boss. You gotta like show them that you in control, my nigga. But yeah, man, I ain't want this story to be really, really long. This was a quick ass story, my nigga. And yeah, it's only 8 minutes. So hopefully y'all murder that like button. You feel me? Hopefully we hit 100K by the day. Today is fucking Sunday. Yeah, Sunday. So I'm recording this kind of early. Yeah. I'm out.